Well, good morning, everyone. Good to see you again. Back from my coffee break. It's a new day. I wanted to start our conversation off today with talking about how much of a light sleeper I am. I need this coffee to help wake up a little bit because I don't sleep quite the same as I used to. Have some of you felt that way over the past 5 or 6 months? I'm a light sleeper. Every little thing goes click in the night. I kind of like perk up and hear it, and then I'm kind of awake, and then I just wait to go back to sleep. I don't just fall asleep. I wait to go back to sleep. I do get some rest, though, and that's good, but I realize that I'm not sleeping as soundly as I could be. So this morning, we could use this coffee break. So go get your coffee, and we'll get started. That's so good. Well, what shall we talk about today? How you feeling? You feeling good? I hope so. I usually start off the morning by trying to sit down and just do a scan of the news. I don't really sit on the news very much because it's too much bad news usually. But I do want to be aware of what's going on and to be aware of how I feel about it. So I do kind of take a peek at the news, if you will. And I did notice all kinds of articles going on out there. And one of them is the wildfires in California in particular. And I just remembered, it's interesting how you think sometimes. You get started on a subject and then your mind connects to another thought and then to another thought. That's kind of what my morning has been like. And it started out with the weather, actually. And the weather is going to be like 109 degrees today. And we're into the triple digits and have been, and usually that's to be expected for July and August where I'm at. We've even been up to 115 degrees already in this area. But we're kind of under heat advisories off and on quite a bit for the last 3 or 4 weeks. But it's hot, and that reminds me about global warming and how things are heating up. And we're not as cool here as we would like to be. But it also causes all these wildfires. Now, we have global warming going on, so it makes me think about, okay, what is the impact on global warming with all this extra heat coming on? How is this all interconnected? Of course, we know a little bit about that from a scientific point of view, and we know lots of people don't agree with global warming and climate change and what have you, but it's kind of a no-brainer to me, if you will, to really look at what's going on weather-wise and not see that something is happening with climate change. And then that's exacerbated by these wildfires. Some of them are sparked by lightning, or it's done by accident. You know, it could be a number of things, but we are having lots of wildfires. And I was thinking, you know, I travel a lot back and forth between California and Nevada quite a bit, at least pre-COVID I did. And I will look forward to that again, but for the last 5 years, at least the last 5 years, it has had nothing but problems about this time of year with wildfires in some way or another. And I have been in that position where I've had to drive along the freeway and drive past fires on the roadside there in certain areas. And I've also been impacted by it because sometimes they will shut down an entire freeway for hours on end. You never know when it's going to reopen, and you have to sort of figure out, well, how am I going to get there from here when the road is closed? So there's a lot of things that happen that are happening because of these fires and this heat and the drought. As a result, there's just a dryness all over the place. These things are all interconnected, aren't they? And they're impacting our lives. Kind of wondering how it's impacting your life, you know, since we're here having these conversations. Let's talk about that a little bit. How's it impacting you? How do you feel about it? Climate change, global warming, heat waves, heat advisories, dryness, the lakes going down, the rivers going down, and then wildfires on top of that. There's a lot going on just in that topic alone, isn't it? And we're all impacted by it, I believe, you know. And I got to thinking about that because I know there has to be some positive side to look at when it comes to all this burning, if you will. And sometimes when we're going through what we're going through with the whole COVID thing and the whole global situation, you know, we're trying to find out where our peace is and where our peace lies within ourselves and around us. And sometimes sitting in the heart of that storm, the eye of the storm, if you will, that's the most peaceful place to be until you get on the other side of it. And I'm looking forward to getting on this other side of it. It's kind of hard to see from here. It's kind of hard to understand. But I believe that we can try to work on being peaceable right here in the right now anyway, despite it all, until we get to that peaceful place, even though we don't quite understand it. But it's there. I know it's there, because when the hurricanes come in, they tell you the eye of the storm is the most peaceful place within the storm. It's calm, it's sunny, the winds are light. I was just looking at this online because I wanted to know more about that. In any case, you know, these things are happening, and I'm thinking, you know, well, here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking, you know, if we as a human race are constantly under the awareness of nothing lasts forever, and things are finite, then are all things finite? We don't think of it in larger terms sometimes. I know when I was in biology class in college, I fought my professor on a paper discussing finite and infinite. Infinite. Is it infinite? Infinite or infinite? Anyways, finite meaning that's it, and infinite meaning going on forever. Yeah, okay. Anyway, I fought him on this on a paper. I actually got a teeny bit of a lower grade because I was trying to explain how I didn't necessarily think that everything was 100% finite. That's it. That's the end. It doesn't go on anymore. Because I think that I believe that things kind of go on in a new way. I mean, we see this with our world, and when the spring comes and the flowers rebloom again, you know, and then they go away and the leaves come and go from the trees, you know, so it's not 100% finite in some respects. So, but then again, you kind of wonder, you know, where are the boundaries for what finite is? Does everything last forever? And I started thinking with the whole global warming and the burning and the wildfires, what have you, that will the sun actually burn off and die away? I mean, I know I've heard that question before, but I've never really looked at the answer. So I went online and I kind of wanted to check out what the answers were with, you know, how long will the sun last? And that's a very big star, you know, and we really don't think of it as going away like we do. I mean, we are like smaller than dog years to the sun, you know, as humans. But in any case, it says in here that the sun is supposed to last up to about 10 billion years, and it's about halfway through its life right now. So that tells me that eventually even the sun will burn away. And then I got to wondering, well, how much further will it go from there? And I found a question listed. You know, if you do a Google search, sometimes you have a list of questions that are asked by other people. And one of those questions was, you know, will the universe die? I think that's what it was. And it said that eventually what will happen is the universe actually expands and grows and gets bigger and bigger and bigger. Eventually, everything that was in the initial universe before it grew to be what it continues to be was able to sustain itself on the resources and the fuels and everything that it needs to keep forming and becoming over and over again to last as long as they do. So eventually, if it just keeps growing to the greater realms of the unknown that we can't all fathom, then everything within the universe will eventually start to fade away and die out too. So in essence, what it was saying was the universe dies out. But maybe it also grows into something else. Who knows? So these are some of my thoughts today. As I'm getting up and getting started and getting going and having my coffee break. And I wondered, you know, if any of you have thought of those kinds of things and what your thoughts are on the idea of the global warming and how it's impacting our lives and what that means to the here and now and to the future. And, you know, how you connect that with the heat waves and the droughts and the wildfires and then the geological disasters that are happening, like the storms that are coming up through the Gulf of Mexico right now. I also had one other thought that is a positive spin on these ideas. You know, earlier I said that one thought connects to another and it's kind of interesting how our brains operate that way, but this is how I am this morning. So anyway, I was thinking that I have seen fires on the long alongside the freeways or roadways where there's some deep ditches and lots of weed overgrowth. And it reminded me of farmers in rural areas. They sometimes purposefully burn their land. It's called prescribed burning. And one of the reasons they do that is to get rid of the old debris and dead debris that's out there. And put the nutrients back into the soil so that it will help their current crops grow. And I thought, oh, okay, well, that's controlled burning, of course, and they're doing it on purpose. The burning is actually producing something good in the end, and it's promoting growth. And I thought, oh, how cool is that? It's, the burning can promote growth if we look at it that way, and if we try to control it in such a way that we take advantage of those properties that help promote the growth through this activity of burning. Boy, that's a lot of stuff to think about this morning on our little coffee break, isn't it? But isn't that kind of nice, though? There is a little hope there, even despite what's going on with the heat waves and the droughts and the fires and what have you, and global warming being what it is. That if we stay in the eye of the storm and we search for our peace beyond all understanding, until we actually reach peace, then our lives are enriched and we have a chance to grow and become a better humanity. And so those are my thoughts for today after scanning the news and you know, replenishing my intake of what's going on with the wildfires and storms and what have you in the world today. And anyway, so those are some of my thoughts. What do you think? You know, I'd love to hear back from you, so please have a conversation with me. You know, we can't see each other face to face, but we can certainly talk to one another in this fashion. And all you have to do is join in the conversation. And how do you do that? Well, you hit that subscribe button down there and the notification bell so you'll know when I'm posting some new conversation, a new coffee break. And be prepared with your cup of coffee or water or tea or juice or whatever you like to have on a coffee break. And then also give me a thumbs up if you liked the video or if you found something interesting in it. Share it with other people. And the most important thing to keep the conversation going is share a comment. You know, tell me your thoughts and your ideas or something that you're experiencing related to the conversation we're having in the video of the day. And or if there's something else you want to talk about in future videos. Would love to hear from you that way. And the way you do that is by posting a comment down in the comments below. And I appreciate you watching the video and sharing this time with me. And I guess that's all I got for you today. So I hope you have a great day, and I look forward to meeting up with you again on our next coffee break. Bye-bye, everybody. Have a good one. Cheers.